So Deva Bhasha, or the Deva means the God. God's language is silence. The whole universe speaks the language of silence actually. Only your Telugu, Malayalam, Tamil is only spoken. Even if you go to a little bit outside a state, that's not spoken. How do you know that? How do you think God will understand it? If Kerala to Karnataka, if you come, I can't understand Malayalam. And do you think God will understand this universal language? The whole universe speaks in one language, it's called silence. That is the language of the divinity. Now, human beings need some language to teach some human beings something in spirituality. They have created a language called Sanskrit. Sanskrit means Sanskrit, refined language. It's a designed language. It's not evolved language. It's designed for communicating truths. Sanskrit means, krit means done. It's refined. After refining human language, they have created Sanskrit. Okay, that's only for communication. So now what is all your stotras, mantras and pujas and all? Your communication to God starts after you complete your stotras in silence. In deep silence, the whole universe speaks. That's the language of the universe. Okay. Stars, planets, galaxies, animals, plants. In that silence, all are one. That's why highest spiritual practice is called silence. Right? So now, the problem of human language, I'll tell you. The human language, whether you take many of these Indian language, Kannada, Tamil, Malayalam, whatever Parala, is that.
Prabhuji, Parala, pointer in both. TV screen will point.
Bharat.
Barala.
Okay.
It's coming.
Your reflection.
No, the reflection
is coming.
It's only the reflection.
Okay, no problem. I'll use the pointer.
Yeah, it's okay.
I'll use this.
There is a pointer.
It's okay. This option. Okay. So we have many languages. Hindi, Kannada, Tamil, Malayalam, English. Okay. Now, what is the problem of this language? Please tell me, you know. The human language has a problem. You know that? The moment you think of something in human language, duality is created, separation is created. Oh God, save me. The moment you say that, the God is separate from you. Okay? I am talking to you. The moment I am talking to you, language comes into picture. I and you comes into picture. Right? Oh God, protect me. That means God is separate from me, deep inside existence. If God is not separate from me, who will protect? He already knows. The language creates a separation. Language inherently dualistic. Are you able to understand? So that the most of our spiritual problems are caused by language actually. Okay? Because whatever you speak in language, the moment you speak, it becomes dualistic. I and you separate out. So, in stotrams, like Vishnu Sahasranama, Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashakkaro, Bhuta Bhavya, Bhavat Prabhu, Bhuta Kar, Bhuta Bhavo, Bhuta Atma, Bhuta Bhavana, Bhuta Atma, Paramatma, Cha, Muktanam, Pravam Gatihi. Right? So in this Vishnu Sahasranama, okay, you are praising God. So there is no I and you. There is just praise. Right? So I am praising is not there. Whereas the moment you say, you do a prayer for yourself, oh God save me, there is a separation which happens. In stotrams, real stotrams, there is no separation. There is only praise. There's no praiser. I am doing that, it's not there. Whereas the moment you start asking for something, there's already a duality created. Can you give me an example?
Many things.
Example.
Like even asatama sadgamaya hendrunu please.
Illa asatama sadgamaya, there's no individual there. It is a statement, invocation. Asato ma sadgamaya, from darkness to light. Tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, from darkness to light. Untruth to truth. Mrityorma amritam gamaya, from death to deathlessness. Om shanti shanti, where is the I and you?
Ma anta barata.
Asato ma sadgamaya. Nama means all of us. Right? So there's a, basically these prayers have less of duality. Okay, whereas the prayers in the deep duality are there.
Papoham, papa karma, papa sambhava.
Yeah, you are actually putting yourself, dipping yourself into. Right? So, do you do dualistic prayers?
So, there are universal prayers and personal prayers. Asatoma sadgamaya is a universal
prayer. Right? And Gayatri Mantra. Burbhuvasuva tatsavitavarune bhargo devesh dhimahi dhiyo yona prachodayat.
Impersonal.
So what happens is the prayers, many of these Sanatana Dharma Vedya prayers they designed are impersonal in nature. Okay? They are stotrams, praise. I am praising you, oh God, I am small, you are big. No, it's not there. And this concept of prayer came into us through Christianity. The Christianity depend on prayers. Okay, so I am a sinner, you protect me. Sanatana Dharma is not like that. There's not a prayer in Sanatana Dharma. Okay. So the human, they understood that human language is inherently dualistic. Whatever you speak, you become duality. Right? So the best language is silence, non-duality. The language of non-duality. So what happens to us is the computers have a language like Python, Java and many other languages, PHP and all. So what is computer language do? They are programming the computer to do some specific task. Alright? Something to be done. Human language is programming a computer called our brain. Okay, anything you do is a input to this machine, and that programming language creates an identity called small I. If there is no human language, there is no small I, doesn't get created at all. See, now you are saying, oh God, I am in trouble. I am in trouble is already started creating trouble. That language itself has created trouble. The entire spiritual problem in life is based on the language actually. No, please don't give me next Janma. Actually, you have started creating a thought of next Janma. I am suffering. Already you started creating suffering. Because the moment you say suffering, the suffering has a lot of qualities. So those qualities come in nature. Okay, God save me. That means you already, God is gone, separated out. The language which you use is the cause of the trouble, spiritual trouble for you. Adi bhautika, adi daimika, adhyatmika trouble is language. Are you clear? So now tell me, what type of prayers you are doing earlier and what are the types of prayers you are doing, and give me an example. So that's why in Sanskrit it's called invocation, that's not called prayer. There's something called stotram. Stotram means praising. Okay? So Vishwam, infinite universe. It doesn't say I and you. Okay, it's called stotram. Then there's invocation. Okay? It should come into my life, into life. Asato, ma, sadgamaya, they're all invocations. Okay? Whereas the praise in Christianity, oh God, save me. That means God is already separated. Very different from Sanatana Dharma prayers and prayers of other language. Please understand. And the prayers are causing confusion in your mind. Can you give, can some people give me example of what type of prayers you are doing?
I want this, I want that.
When is my next promotion?
So, every prayer you are strengthening the I, ego. And this is happening because of the language.
What about Mrityunjaya?
Yeah, ready. Sugandhim Pushtivardhana Urvarukam Vabandhana Mrityor Mokshiya Ammam Amritat. For me, liberate me. Right? There is a duality in that.
Chamakadallo ashte.
Okay. Then there is a another it doesn't mean that duality is not to be used in prayer. Okay. When you are in dukkha, when you are suffering, the dukkha is because already you are separated out. Okay. Dukkha, you are already separated out. Mm-hmm. Suffering. So then the prayers will have duality in Sanatana Dharma. So already I am feeling a separation is there. Dukkham, I am suffering. Dukkham. I am already in trouble. So there, the prayers in Sanatana Dharma will have duality. Otherwise, there are three levels of prayers. One is praise, stotram.
Chants.
Stotram. It is not I and you. Glory of God. Okay? There is no I and you. That's called stotram. Second thing is invocation. Something comes into my life. Okay? There I don't start with the negative. It's not there in me. Okay? Please understand. There is no negative in me. Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityor ma amritamgamaya. From darkness to light. Okay? So there is a prayer. Then there is a prayer where I am suffering. So then already you are in duality. Already in duality. And in that duality, there is a prayer. Right? Here, even in that prayer, there is no negative stress. It's already a positive only stress. Okay? It doesn't say, I am suffering. Please show me the path, show me the light. In essence, the language is inherently dualistic. Okay? Whenever you have to speak to your husband, already duality is created. Whenever you speak to your wife, the duality is created. And all your mental talk is duality. So there is a head, there is a guy in your head. Alright? He constantly talks. In which language he talks?
Duality.
Huh?
Mother tongue.
Ah.
Mother.
He talks in mother tongue. Right? He can't even talk in English also. In Sri Krishna Devaraya, in his Astana, court. There are in court. This court, there are nine people. Nine jewels. Okay, they are experts in each of their field. The tradition of that day, if anybody comes to the king's court, they'll challenge these nine people, and if any of them is defeated, they'll vacate the seat, and this person will occupy the seat. So, one pandita came. Let me see, one more chair. So one pandita came, and that pandita challenge the people in the Krishnadevaraya's court.
I
speak 80 languages so fluently. Can anybody find out which is my mother tongue? He is so good in any language. Any language you ask question, he talks fluently and as if he is a native speaker. People don't understand. Then Krishnadevaraya was horrified. He asked Tinalram Krishna, can you do something about it? Then I'm sure, yes. So one day this pandita, he was sleeping in this room. Because he had been a royal guest house. Tinalrama goes and pours one bucket of water on his head. Suddenly he starts shouting in Telugu. The first thing in your mind comes is your mother tongue. Okay? The guy in your head, constantly there is a comment going on, running commentary going on, right? In your head. And the running comment, the language of that guy, you look, observe. It's your mother tongue. Huh? You understand? So I am in trouble. What to do? Huh? Yo, what the hell is going on?
this guy is troubling me, that guy is troubling you. Nobody is troubling you. That guy inside your head is troubling you. No, I want to get Advaita. Oh, how told you about Advaita? Nobody told you Advaita. The programming language has programmed this guy head inside. Are you separate from God any point of time? And this language has separated you. Understand? We were speaking about universal language, okay? The language God understands. Which is that language?
Language of our mind.
Silence. The whole universe understands only silence. The entire universe. Only the noise is created by your mind. And that in your mother tongue, actually. What happened if there is no language in the world now? There is no spirituality, there is no prayer, there is no God, there is already silence. You are like, everybody is peaceful.
All are God only.
See, the entire spiritual journey I have to do sadhana, this sadhana, that sadhana. My dear, what you are trying to remove is a problems created by language you are trying to remove, that's all. Other than that, there's Advaita only, non-duality only is there. Understand? Clear to all? So that's why it is said that all enlightened people, they speak, they talk in silence. Okay, Dakshinamurti was talking in silence. He was teaching in silence. Ramana Maharshi was teaching in silence. The purpose of teaching in silence is anything you speak, it creates a duality. So now I'll say, Atmadnana, full of bliss. Just one, two words is Atmadnana means bliss. Immediately the guy in your head starts creating bliss. How can that bliss be? So the bliss is like that, he'll start running commentary. Then you'll miss the bliss because bliss is silence. You understand? So that's why, na ayam atma pravajane labhyaha. So you log in 10,000 hours of spiritual satsang. It is only creating the mental noise, that's all. Have you really practiced silence in your life?
Distraction.
Silence is distraction.
No, practice more distraction
more
than
distraction.
Right?
So, the spiritual practice, great spiritual practice is silence. In silence, you are one with God. So now, do one small practice and see how beautiful, how blissful your life will be. When your husband comes, be silent. When your wife comes, be silent. 10 minutes, 15 minutes you practice, then husband will ask, when is Prabhuji's next class? Please understand, silence is great spiritual practice because your head is messed up with the language. Messed up by language. You understand? Just like a computer gets programmed by many of the computer languages, your head is getting programmed by languages, especially your mother tongue. Yeah. And you go to psychologist. You start pouring. The psychologist gets programmed by that language of the patient, and he is also trying to program that guy. Tell me, when are you coming out of this guy head? The guy who is sitting in your head, constantly chattering, and this guy is totally a product of language. The entire spirituality is get rid of this guy.
It's on. It is on.
Yeah. Clear, Napa? So, what is the best prayer?
Silence.
What is the difference between prayer and meditation?
There is no language.
Huh?
Meditation is silence. Prayer is duality.
So prayer is constantly talking to God. Okay? like you are talking as if God is your husband or wife. Meditation is listening to God. Right? Do you listen to God or do you talk to God?
First we need to talk and tell him, understand, you know, what we are going through.
The moment you say him, you already separate out. Okay, as then he has become deaf because he can't listen to what's happening in your head. If you're silent, you can listen what's happening. Right? The spirituality is actually, we think that mukti, jivan mukti, liberation, jiva is going, this thing. Nothing, my dear, it's trying to solve the problem created by your language. Where did the concept of life after life, birth after death, but came to picture? Your language only. Otherwise, we are just peaceful only with the universe. Right? So, let us speak the language of the universe. Dakshinamurti spoke in, taught in silence. Right? And there are some rishis sitting here, right? Now, again, the moment say rishis, something started clicking in your head. Okay, what is started clicking in head? Oh, Rishi's must guard with the beard, guy with the beard. Okay, he's looking, he's an old man. Okay, he's sitting near the Dakshinamurti.
And on the top of Himalaya.
On top of Himalaya. So, all images started because of language. Right? These Rishis are nothing but Jivas. Jivas are old. You are all very, very old guys. Millions of years old. That's why Rishis, anywhere in the Upanishad, Rishis did 20,000 years of tapasya. He is about you only. You are so old, you don't even recognize. And Dakshinamurti, you started thinking, oh, he's a guy who is sitting in Himalayas. No, the Guru is Dakshinamurti. The Guru who teaches Atmadana is Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti means one who is facing the south. Okay, south is direction of death. Okay, all jivas are running towards death, south. Those who want to escape from death, they look for north, towards jnana. And the guru is sitting there trying to give jnana. He is looking south. So all gurus, all atmanjnani gurus are Dakshinamurtis only. Now you start thinking, oh, I will pray to Dakshinamurti. One day Dakshinamurti will come and save me. Your mind creates so many images. Are you clear? So the prayer is required for praising. Okay? Praise God. Prayer is required for invoking something in your life. Okay? When you are distressed, you pray. Please save me. So the prayers are three types. Don't get confused by the prayers of the other religions. They are actually messed up something more in your head. Clear? Any questions? Clear? You are not telling that, sir? Well, okay.
In the morning, if I sit for puja, sindhya, or whatever it is, I am going to sit for half an hour.
Right.
I decide and sit, you know. I decide and sit for half an hour.
Correct.
And then there again, duality comes, you know. Even if it's praying or spoken, whatever it is.
Yes.
I am praying. I am going to pray today, tomorrow.
So that's why he said, O Lord, you are in me, you are doing the prayer and being offered to you. The Lord has to be invoked in you first before you pray. It's not I am praying. The Lord in my heart.
There is a perception, you know, I am going to pray.
Yeah, that perception has to be removed. By understanding that Lord in my heart is enabling the prayer in me. He is the one who is praying through me for himself. I am not there.
Prana pratishthapana.
All those things.
Nyasa.
Invoking. Invoking various parts of the body, invoke the Lord. Right? So, what's happening is, without understanding this, your prayer becomes dualistic and it deepens whatever you are trying to achieve through prayer. So you heard of this Nyasa and Prana Pratishtha, Nyasa?
Yes.
Om Borbuha Swaha. Then you install the consciousness, Chaitanyam, in your heart, in your head, in your business. So the whole body is filled with the divinity. Then feeling of I amness, separateness reduces. So then there is a puja. You have to do Shiva puja. Then you have to invoke Shiva in you to do puja. If you do as Jiva, then there is a separation. If you do Shakti puja, invoke Shakti in you and do puja. So this is actually the way of Sanatana Dharma, puja. Right? Don't create feeling of separation by your language.
So what about expression of gratitude? Is it dualistic? Thank you for giving me all this today.
Gratitude is...
Is it dualistic?
No. The moment you speak language, it becomes dualistic.
No, even
so,
thinking.
Okay, so I mean, what I'm saying is, so, how many times you thank your mother every day? So she put some salt. Thank you, mother. Will you say that? Do you do that? Why? You're not thankful?
It's feeling.
We are, but we don't express.
Actually, the life itself should be gratitude. Okay, the moment you express in the word, that value will go, because you are only recognizing that particular act, right? So
I mean a feeling, the expression of the feeling of gratitude for everything that has
the highest expression is silence. So this whole concept of prayer and thankfulness has come from not from us, not from Sanatana Dharma.
So even that is redundant, actually.
All the shlokas and stotras are from that picked up from...
Give me now, one shloka you tell me now. Tell me one shloka, which is...
Vishnu Sahasra.
Yeah, it is a praise. It is not prayer. There is a difference between praise and a prayer.
Sir, in Vishnu Sahasra, Palashruti is...
Then Falashruti somebody has added later to motivate people. That is for motivation of people.
Okay.
Otherwise, you will not do Vishnu Sahasranama. So, there is a very, very different between praise and prayer. Okay. Praise is stotram, stuti. Okay. There is no duality there. Shall we go? So, now, let us sit in silence, simple silence. Okay. So, in that silence, what you do? Your guy in the head will make noise. And which language is talking, you please find out. What language he talks? What? I think nowadays people are that guy has learned English also. People are not even able to think in mother tongue.
Think in English and translate into mother tongue.
Mother tongue. So sit silently, okay? In that silence, become one with the universe, the totality. The moment you sit silently, you are already one with God. You don't have to do anything. There is no sadhana required. No Advaita sadhana, Advaita sadhana. Advaita sadhana that guy in the head is doing. Tell me, friends, what is Advaita sadhana? There was never a separation. The separation is created by language. Clear? Okay. Let us sit silently. This silence is the language of the universe. Our ancestors always stressed on that silence. That's why they said Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Shanti mantra, they give a lot of importance. The whole universe speaks the language of silence. The stars, the planets, the galaxy, the sky, animals, the trees, the plants, the river, everybody speaks the language of silence. The silence is the divine language. Just sit in silence. The silence is the greatest prayer. Silence is meditation. Silence is oneness with God. In that silence, we become one with the universe, one with God. Thank you.
asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shantihi
om shanti shanti shanti
lokah samastah
lokah samastah
sukino bhavantu
sukino bhavantu
lokah samastah
lokah samastah
sukino bhavantu
sukino bhavantu
lokah samastah
lokah samastah
sukino bhavantu
sukino bhavantu
harihi om
harihi om
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Shri Gurubhyo Namaha 99% of your problems, spiritual problems are solved the moment you learn how to be silent. Any questions? The language is the cause of your problem. The language is cause of psychological disorder in human beings. The language becomes the language of this guy in the head, that's the ego. So now when you said silent, was there any thought came up? Which language the thought comes up? Mother tongue. Right? If you understand the problem caused by language, 99.5% of your spiritual problems are solved. There's no duality at all. The language causes duality. Any doubts? Don't have to agree with you because of what I say. You may disagree also. Every day morning I get a dream and then I create some new ideas. So it may not be right also.
You are deaf and dumb people.
Deaf and dumb people.
Deaf and dumb same.
If they don't learn sign language or whatever, then how is the...
They have a self-identity. I am the body identity is there. But there is no mental chatter. Mental chatter is very little. Mental noise. See, ultimately we are speaking of mental noise. Constant noise in the mind. Okay, they keep seeing people, that creates mental noise. Okay, now they don't know the language. So that language, the noise doesn't get strengthened. It'll be momentary.
But they'll be having perceptions, right?
They'll be?
Do they have perceptions because they're not able to think, right?
No, I'm saying the language keeps building thoughts. Right? That dies. The moment there is a pain, there is a pain. After that, it doesn't leave residue. Mm-hmm. Any Satyavati clear today?
Depending, like they can see. Different
of it,
but they can see. So they will have visuals.
They have
there is no language.
No, that visual images is there. They start linking with each other. Mm-hmm. See, that's a visual language. Okay. So one image, okay, this guy came and hit me. Some day back he came and hit me. They get linked. That becomes a visual language. Okay. The entire spirituality is trying to come out of the language problems, whether it's visual or auditory or verbal. So you come out. The moment you come out, you are at peace. You are one with God. Constantly they create images. That images will keep coming up. So they saw you. Okay. That the other day you shouted at him. So that image will come up. That becomes a visual language.
So something is going on always.
Andre? Clear the Ramakrishna? Padmalochan?
Silence.
So, spend some time in silence every day. especially when your husband or wife is in front of you. Okay, that's good for your health and good for your cause. You are contributing the spiritual upliftment of the family at least. So now let us come to okay. When you are born to your mother, how many children were born? When you are born to your mother, how many children were born? Single. Single, not twins, not triplet, huh? Five, quadruplet, or anything like that. Only single. Sure. Everybody sure that there only one child was born? Ashwini?
You are not born only, right?
Two. Which are the two?
One is the child and one is the mother.
Mother is also a child.
Rebirth
for her also. Okay. So, when any child is born, a triplet is born. Three children are born. You know that? She knows better actually. She has the twins actually. Two children plus mother also is born. Three. So, a triplet is born. Three children are born. Okay. So, who are these three children? Who are these three children? First child is from the father and mother. Okay? The father and mother give one cell each. They help to create the body of the child. They are bodybuilders. Okay? This is called biological child. Right? So whatever you call as a body is the product of the biological child. Okay. Then the second child, the biological child cannot survive. The consciousness is required, Chaitanyam. There's a divine child which came from Shiva and Shakti. The universal father, universal mother, Vishnu and Lakshmi. The universal father and universal. They give a divine child, which is consciousness, Chaitanyam. Okay. So, how many children are born now at the time of birth? Two. Then another child is also born. It's called society child, third. Okay. The society child is called the mind. So, your entire mind is contribution of the society. Thoughts, thinking, feelings, emotions, everything is activated by the society. So, the three children are born. The divine child. The divine child is not really born, it's a visiting. Okay, it's not born, it's not dying. It's just visiting. Human child is born. Then after some time, the society child starts getting birth. How much, after how much time?
11
days. Namakarana. The day the mother and father, okay, now, they see the beautiful child, peace and really pleasant and happy and all. My child has to become like me only. They give the name. The name starts separating out the child. Till that time it doesn't know. Okay, it is one with the universe. Right? Now the mother starts programming the child, father starts programming the child, grandparents, TV, mobile phone, the society. Okay, by the age of 18, the child is fully programmed and ready for operation in the world. Understood? The programming is complete. Bhagavad Gita class, Vandra? Bhagavad Gita class,
you didn't
Bhagavad Gita class, illa? ನಿಮಿಷ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತೆ ಜೂನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜೂನಿಂದ ಜೂನ್ ಹಾ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಸಮರ್ ಹಾಲಿಡೇ ಈಗ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಇನಫ್ ಟು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಮ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಮಗು ನನ್ನ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡಪ್ಪ ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಆಗುವಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇನ್ನೋಸೆಂಟ್ ವೆರಿ ನಾಯ್ ವೆರಿ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಏಜ್ ಆಫ್ 17-18 ವೇರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಓಕೆ ದರ್ ಆರ್ 3 ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಸೊ ದ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಫಾದರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮದರ್ ದ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಫಾದರ್ ಮದರ್ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಮದರ್ ಶಿವ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶಕ್ತಿ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಫಾದರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್
countless
fathers countless mothers and what's the such child is called what bekashanappa bekashamma iro magu yen ant heltarappa neevu
actually anathra
it's called in english there's a very nice word for that bastard anta right okay so there are 3 children one is divine child another is human child another is a society child okay clear and these children are very very close to each other they are not separated out they are actually very very
sandwiched
right now one child cries you don't know which child is crying it appears as though all the children are crying right my mother had many children we are 6 children they were very close so one child will hit other child will cry and within no time some 3 children are crying my mother doesn't know which child is crying for what reason okay so like that these 3 are very very close you cannot separate them out easily right the human child has a problem what is the problem of human child problem is what human child is born it grows up it has a leg pain then back pain joint pain fever cough cold it's a physical problem or the problem of the human child right human child cries because of this physical problem hunger thirst and cry it's called biological needs what are the problems of society change huh
thoughts are this problem
huh
thoughts are this problem
which problem most problem
society
child is always crying
thoughts are this problem
language so society is constantly crying all the time it cries only right What about divine child? What is the problem?
No. Actually, nothing.
It's actually, peaceful. Silent. Right? It is always peaceful and silent. But it also appears to be crying. Because of these two? Other two. Right? Now, out of this, who are you? Out of these triplets, who are you?
We are actually divine child. We get confused with the society and I.
I means who?
The divine child.
Okay. Why are you confused with the society child?
Because I have forgotten the language of the God.
All your problems are because of society child. The divine child, which is you, has no problem. Biological child is born, grows up and dies one day. Okay? Society child is never happy. Right? For whom is the sadhana required, spiritual practice required?
Not at all.
For who has to know? Human child has to know? Or the society child has to know? Or divine child has to know?
Society.
Prita, you understood problem? Who requires the spiritual sadhana? Society child is, it can't understand.
Correct.
It's only noise.
We have to log out of .com. Loss of memory is the .com.
.com.
We have to log out.
So Prita, Prita, whom is the spiritual practice, sadhana?
Actually, no need of
sadhana. No need of sadhana. But what? So, Padmanajan?
So, question is to whom the sadhana?
There are three children are in you, right? For who is the doing sadhana?
No, in addition to these three children, there is a delusion, no? That
the delusion is, yeah, the delusion is,
I am
this. No, no, this is, because, this is because these three are fused together. The delusion is the fusing of these together. Separation, immediately separation, it'll be free.
True.
Whole Vedanta is to separate this out. The delusion is because they are so close to each other. You understood? Ashwini?
The mind has to know that it doesn't exist.
Huh?
So the society
tells it. Society what?
Has to know, the mind has to know that it doesn't.
Society child claims that I am the divine child. It says, I am unhappy. Society child says, I am unhappy. That I belong to the divine child. Okay? The divine child is silent. Okay?
What she says is correct. The mind has to know that it doesn't exist.
Huh? How?
So that is why the society child needs sadhana, right? So that it can
society child has no independent existence. See, society child is borrowing the strength from the divine child and claiming that I am the divine child. Okay. Now what has happened to divine child actually in this galata, tamasha which is going on?
Nothing.
The divine child is observing this drama and so absorbed in the drama. What I'm saying is the divine child has come here to witness what's going on. Sakshi.
Sakshi.
But Sakshi is so involved in the drama that Sakshi thinks he is in trouble. That's why he supports these guys. He doesn't know the separation. The entire Vedanta teaching is not for the society child. Entire Vedanta teaching is for the Sakshi, the divine child, which is mixed up these guys.
Match fixing.
Match fixing over here. The divine child in this tamasha is starts thinking, oh, I am also in trouble. The society child, there is no point, it is no father, no mother, it is an orphan. So whatever you teach, it doesn't work for that guy. Okay, human child, anyway, the problems are continuing, like leg pain, the stomach pain. Okay. The divine child is thinking, I am this. It is getting mixed up. So, divine child has to be awakened. Wake up. Okay, awaken the divine child in you. The divine child is sleeping, thinking that I am the human child. Thinking that I am the...
But divine child doesn't think.
No, it is using this. It's an instrument. See, your glasses... When you use the glass, so the glasses are giving a feeling for you. That is what's happening to divine child. The knowing principle is only divine child. Either case, I don't have the knowing ability. Got it? Nothing has happened to divine child, but it got... It is in a dream. Dream like stage of human child and society child is superimposed on that. Right? Now who are you here really? Are you the society child? Then why you say I am disturbed? Huh? If you are a society child, you have to accept that you are a bastard. Does the word sound nice? Are you clear on what I'm saying? Huh? What are you?
Technically consciousness or the divine child.
Okay, technically.
Confused with the body.
And how can this confusion be removed? How can the confusion be removed?
Silence.
Atma vichara. inquiry. If I ask you questions, then mind will start. Okay, this is the only way. No, I will sit in meditation for 10,000 hours. This is all the problem. 10,000 hours, the diva society child will be quiet. You are forcing the 10,000. After that, suddenly you will wake up. Again, problem start. The clarity has to emerge. Understanding has to be very, very clear. Jnana. Is it clear, Preeta? Anybody has question? Artha Tindre? Doubt?
Clear.
But that jnana is coming in momentarily, but that has to be stabilized. No?
That's what I mean. That's the shravana, manana, nididhyasa.
Firming up.
Firming up. Nididhyasa. Okay, there's no other way. See, this guy is the knower. So now the read jnana has to read this guy through this human child and society child. The society child refuse. It's fight back. So it has to penetrate. I'm the divine child. These guys are making noise.
Yeah, that comes, but that doesn't stay there.
Right. So are you clear?
So all teaching is for the mixed up divine child.
It's a superimposed. Nothing has happened. Nothing can happen to the divine child.
So when Vasishtha taught Rama, he was addressing the mixing up of Rama with the prince.
This society, prince. See, the sentient principle is only the divine child. Others are just superimposed. So now the superimposed guys are causing confusion to the sentient. Uttishtanarashadula. Right? Wake up. Right? Wake up. Clear? Any questions? ನೀವ್ಯಾರ ಅಪ್ಪ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ದುಃಖ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ಯಾರದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ದುಃಖ ಆಯ್ತು ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ನೆವರ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಸಫರ್ಸ್ ಏನೇ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್
The society child is small I and divine child is
bigger. No, it's combination is I. This combination has become I, the divine child is witness. But the whole combination has become small I. Until you separate out. After you separate out, this becomes witness, Sakshi. Until you separate out, it's all mixed up. That is superimposition. Chidabhasala. Adhyasa. Ella super, ella mix up. ಈಗ ಹಗ್ಗ ಮತ್ತು ಹಾವು ಅದ್ರ ಹಗ್ಗ ಯಾವುದು ಹಾವು ಯಾವುದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಆರೋಪ
ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ಸರಿನಾ ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ವೈಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಮೆಝಾನಲ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಎಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಅಮೆಝಾನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಫೋನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಯು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಂತ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಮೆಝಾನ್ ಬುಕ್ಸು ಅಂಗಡಿಯಿಂದ ಶಾಪಿಂದ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಶಾಪ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಮೆಝಾನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ಓಪನ್ ಇಟ್ The product is seen. If the product is damaged, what you'll do? You'll send back. Amazon will accept. But if you don't, if you do the damage to the product, what will happen to you? Amazon will not accept. Right? Same thing is happening here also. when the mother and father ordered the product from the God, Ashwini, okay, it was come in a very nice package condition. Sometimes 2-in-1. Buy one, get one free. Ashwini got that offer, right? Buy one, get one free. So it comes in a very nice package condition.